Anything new? Have you seen many wonderful things in your travels, stranger? I hear the city of Athkatla is so huge it could hold 1 million people, and the streets there are littered with gold coins that the nobles just throw away. Do not be silly, my son. Athkatla is a dark and dirty place where the Rom are not welcome. You would be disappointed, I think. Are they supposed to be Romanians? Well, how do you know, Mama, if you've never been there? Don't speak to your mother in such a manner, Mastab says. But I never talked to her like... No. Enough, Chidek. I know because I know, my son. One day you'll be old enough that you may go there if you wish, but you will see that I am telling the truth. Well, what do you think, stranger? Is the City of Coin really so bad as my mother says? It is a difficult and dirty place, Chidek, but it is not a terrible place to live if one chooses to. Oh? I had thought it would be so beautiful. But if it is not such a bad place, I think I would like to visit it someday. But not today, my son. You are young yet, and such a journey can wait. I suppose you're all right, Mama. I'm going to go for a walk. I won't go into the town, though, and I won't be long. Are you just walking to Athkatla? Of course, my son. Be safe. Remember, you have many years ahead to do all the things you wish, and you will have the wisdom then to deal with them. Well, oh, he went in there. Wait a second.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Okay, I don't see him. Apparently he went to get his rocks off. I don't know.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
Papa says we're going to be going home soon. I like the forest better. The trees are so big, and the elves people treat us real nice. Okay, here's the father, Mastiff. You won't. Okay. You're welcome in our tent, who are a hero in this place. We will soon return to our forest, I think, now that the creatures do not attack us Rom any longer. Oh, yeah, okay. She never sees anyone's future. Let us in.
I shall follow your strength.
I understand.
Jesus.
Stand back. For the bigger they are, the harder
what?
I hit.
Such menial tasks.
Really had trouble getting in here.
A simple matter.
I'd be sorry, but I can't talk now. I must ready the drivers to head back to Moran. Now that the troubles are over, we've been commissioned to restock the town.
Greetings, good customer. A pearl to you.
On behalf of my husband and I thank you for everything you have done. Our caravans have been restored to prosperity. Wherever we go, we shall tell of your good deed, dear woman. Oh, thank you. If you had any stuff in the tent to take, I would steal it. Alright, let's... Yeah, I think we missed this tent.
Ever see battle, Bo? Run, Bo, run!
Maybe not. I don't know. This one we can't go in. Let's hope we can get in this one. This one's empty.
Make way, villainy! Butt kicking! For goodness!
Caravan merchant.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Buy whatever we wish. used a couple of them. Yeah, that's all I really want. Should I sell some stuff to him? To get rid of some of these arrows with the smaller amounts. Arrows of fire. Alright, because I have stacks of 80. I have 160 arrows of fire. I think we have enough arrows of fire. Arrow plus one, we have acid arrow plus one. We just happen to have exactly that many. Arrow of biting. Yeah, that's all I'm going to get rid of, actually. See if there's anything I'd like to. What container am I in? I thought I was in the scroll case. Oh, this is the scroll case. Okay. Like, this is all stuff that can become, that can be rather useful at some point. Potions. Keep those then. Ring of Earth Control, maybe we'll keep that. Or Druid's Ring? It's not even that expensive. There's a few of these gems, like the Sunstone gem I want to hold on to. Didn't I? Oh, Rogue Stone is up there. Right. I'm gonna keep some of this stuff. Okay. And then dare you not buy my steaks. Okay, get rid of this studded leather armor. Some of this stuff I'm just keeping around for people we bring on. club, axe, sword, staff. Two-handed sword. Mostly just the plus one weapons. Medium shield. That's a small shield plus two. Okay, still a bunch of stuff. Let me just double check, make sure I don't have like any two parentheses. Oh yeah, leather armor plus one. Oh, I sold both the short bows. Well, I still have this bow somewhere. Elven court bow, yeah. Okay. Thank you very much.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I live by the sword. Live a good long time.
Hmm. Those genies were doing nothing but causing problems. It's good to see that they've been dealt with at last. I don't think we could have done it ourselves.
Flowers are beautiful, aren't they, Boo? I wish there were more to see.
There is, if we go somewhere where there are flowers.
I see you have an appreciation for the small things, Minsk. You see the power of simple nature.
I don't understand much that is complicated, but the trees and the flowers are music to my eyes. Boo prefers the calm of the forest, though he suffers my company. Ah, you are his tree amidst the cities and people, and despite your bending and bowing in the wind, you are his stability, as I suspect he is yours. No, he is my hamster. You talk in circles, Cernd, but that's okay. Boo runs in them. Okay.
Declare yourself.
Oh, he says the same thing. Militia Captain, you have done much for us, my lady. You have made my job much easier and restored peace to the town. I hope you always feel welcome here. Hopefully that one peasant still doesn't want to attack us. He's probably said that already. This little area back here, have I been back here? I mean, I must have because it's cleared out. There's nobody in there, there's nothing in there. Let's head down to the market.
Hi, friend.
Ah, if it ain't the heroes of the town, come to take advantage of me peddling, no doubt. I'd be more than pleased to sell you what I can, now that me cart be full once again. A tip of me hat to you, sir. Oh. I didn't realize a window would actually come up. Okay. That's all we want, some healing potions.
Oh.
This is his, right? Yeah, this is his, and I gave this to him. There's some bullets. Oh. He knows hookers, what? Right, so we got 4, 4, 1. We'll get some more from Wallace.
I need a swig of some strong dwarven ale.
And I need me potions of healing. Different looking skull case. Here's mine. Okay. All they really have is some potions of healing for us. My mom says you're a hero. Can I be a hero too if I try real hard?
As long as you're not a jackass.
Greetings. An hero of our town in my very own shop. I am pleased to see you and offer you my own personal thanks for what you have done for us. Now that we've the caravans coming into town once again, Trademeet is once again an appropriate name for our town. Heh. Black blood, +3. This oak club is coated with darkened, dried globs of a tar-like substance. During battle, the substance grows black with an inner light and becomes thick and fluid. When the club strikes an opponent, it delivers additional acid damage from the liquid splashing over the victim. Thaco is 1. Thaco is +3, and damage is 1d6 +3, and then +3 acid damage. Interesting. Anyone but mage can use it. Dwarven thrower? That would be good for trolls. Dwarven thrower +3. This hammer, not to be confused with the elven named dwarf thrower, is only usable by dwarves. In the capable hands of a dwarven warrior, the hammer may be thrown at an opponent. The magic in the hammer draws it back to the hand of its wielder. If it hits an opponent, it does double the normal damage that a hammer would normally do. Against giants and ogres, the hammer does an additional +8 damage, due to the special hatred that dwarves hold against these races. Returns to the wielder's hand when thrown. Thaco is +3. Damage is 2d4 +3, or 2d4 +8, versus giants and ogres. Crushing or missile. Interesting. 10 Sharon's bow +3. The thin, frayed string of this bow appears unusable, but when it is drawn, a solid but invisible arrow becomes tangible. The Lich Tancharan gave this bow to his watcher, the guardian of his keep who stood atop a tower with neither entrance nor exit. When anyone approached, down would fall a never-ending rain of phantom arrows until they were dead or fled. How this bow was wrested from the watcher's hand is not known, but would probably make a great tavern story. Note, avoid equipping normal arrows on your character, else the bow will fire these instead of the phantom arrows. When no arrows are equipped, the bow fires missiles that are treated as +3 for the purposes of determining what enemies they can damage. The missiles receive +3 to hit, including the bonus, can't talk, listed below, and deal a total of 1d6 missile damage. That's funny. Including the bonus listed below. Is this the bonus? Plus 3 to hit. What says plus 3? Yeah, I'm not sure what that little thing means, including the bonus listed below. Raz the Dancing Blade? Beowulf was a barbarian who traveled from the cold north in search of adventure. He sought treasures and glory, but soon all he wanted were companions to share in the excitement of battle, much like those he had left behind in his faraway village. Unfortunately, his coarse remarks and rudimentary hygiene repelled most travelers he met, until he expressed his thoughts to a sympathetic mage. The mage, for a price, constructed Rast, the Dancing Blade. Though not quite what Beowulf had in mind, he was thrilled nonetheless and wielded this sword for many years. How they were ultimately separated is not known. Dancing sword can attack on its own for 2 rounds. 1d8 plus 2. Does that go plus 2? Huh. Interesting. But not interesting enough that I want to buy it. Let's get some bullets. This is 5 stacks of 40. Right. Chainmail plus 2. Small shield plus 2. Take all these. Belt of inertial barrier. When worn, this belt creates a dense curtain of air around the wearer. This curtain or barrier provides superior protection against breath attacks as well as magic. By the scorch marks on the worn leather, it is obvious that this belt has been worn at least once against a dragon. So it's save versus breath plus 3, resistance to missile damage plus 25%, and magic damage plus 50%. That's good to reduce the missile and magic damage. Especially the magic damage that much. But let's save our money for now, I guess.
Who you may find yourself, eye to eye, face to face.
Fish to fish. Oh, I can't. I can't equip it because of that. I forgot. I took the other one out. A large assortment of bows. Alright, so where's the rest of these? Use up that tiny stack first, I guess. Give me one. All right, so I got 5, 5, 5, 5, 4, and 7. Healing potions all around.
That's
faster than Chiktika Fast Paws.
Stand back for justice!
Well, now I can actually go to merchants and stuff here. Alright, stand by, guys. I will be right back. Okay. So let's check out the pub.
See battle, Boo! Run, Boo! Run!
I think they might have to stay in here. Well, there's the peasant who doesn't like us. Alanina. Amac.
Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
Who are you?
Ah, you're those people with the swords and spells and scars and stuff. Ah! Get out of my way. You were the one who performed those deeds up in the Sword Coast, yes? I thought you seemed familiar. I have heard a few wondrous tales pass from a fellow bard named Garrick. And we never did have him in our party. Lady Morana. Children at her feet. I am waiting for a particular gentleman, friend, but if you are so inclined, I would be more than willing to spend the evening with such a handsome man as yourself.
Declare yourself!
Lurraxol guard says, get away from me, Alibakkar scum! I'll not have your filthy hands upon me. Alibakkar guard says, do not flatter yourself, Lurraxol pig. If I were to touch you, it would be to throw you out, and that is all. Do not speak to me like that. I serve the first noble trade of first noble family of Trademeet. He's so angry he can't get his words out. The Lurraxols are nothing more than peasants. I laugh at your ignorance, fool. Laugh at me, huh? I'll show you who's the commoner. Alibakkar whoreson. You called him a whoreson. Can I? Oh, they're attacking each other. Hey, hey! Oh, they just say the same things.
I'll test your metal with cold steel.
I can't attack them, otherwise we'll have problems. Just have to see who wins, I guess.
Do not disturb my duties.
The fool. He should have known better than to take on an Alibakkar better. I spit upon his foul body. Batui. Well, he could have had better equipment. Alright. What about Olma? I don't think she says much, though.
Take a look at me, diddy.
Yeah, this is the same thing she said, I think.
Never had rats. No, sorry.
Well, if it isn't the heroes who have saved the town, well met, my lord. Do come in and have a seat. You're more than welcome in Vyatri's inn. What can I do for you? What can you tell me about the feud between the Lurraxols and the Alibakkars? Ah, both of those families are fools. Rich fools. Nobody but them really cares which is the true founding family, and if Lord Logan is correct, they stem from the same family anyway. But they'll never believe that. Their relations and guards have been battling for many years, sometimes to open violence. One of these days, they will take it too far. I'd say they just did. There's someone killed right in front of you, in your own establishment. Anything for the heroes of Trademeet. Oh, he doesn't sell stuff.
Do not touch me. Speak and be done with it.
The militia wizard sighs and says, I suppose this had to happen. Now that things have been restored to normal, the feud begins once again. Those two failures have been nothing but problems in this town. I am surprised Lord Logan doesn't order their death. They certainly are asking for it if scenes like this continue. Attention, everyone. There will be no further brawling in this area, or any involved will be arrested. You all know how the Lurraxols and Alibakkars can be, yes? Do not get involved, I warn you. Lord Logan will be informed of this incident immediately. Calm down and return to your business at once. Don't do anything, just sitting around talking.
You're a stranger.
Well, you saved Trademeet, didn't you? Yeah, we did, kid. Get out of our way.